This is BALTOPS. It's one of the largest exercises in Europe. 50 ships, 2 submarines, 36 aircraft, and more than 8,000 troops. But this year's exercise is led by a commander not permanently based in Europe, but one based half a world away in Norfolk, Virginia. U.S. Vice Admiral Woody Lewis, the commander of the American Second Fleet, tells VOA the small fleet's flexibility is one of its biggest advantages.
I could be with a small part of my staff on board this ship or on board an aircraft carrier or in an austere location somewhere else.
The Second Fleet guards the North Atlantic and the Arctic. It was shut down in 2011 after a series of downsized military budgets. And back then, those waters didn't need a lot of protection. But times have changed. Top U.S. military leaders say Russia is on the prowl at levels not seen since the end of the Cold War. And China is also operating in the region.
So when we're planning these exercises and we go out and we operate with our ships and our aircraft, we are thinking about China and Russia in how we're going to win this high-end fight.
And the United States is not the only one concerned. NATO has created a new command to counter a resurgent Russia in the North Atlantic. Vice Admiral Lewis heads that command, too. NATO's Supreme Allied Commander Transformation, who heads the alliance's future military strategy development, tells VOA the new operational command will reinforce the link between North America and Europe amid growing global instability.
So it is a concrete way that proves that the alliance is adapting today, because we need to be fed by the lessons learned coming from the field in order to adapt our own capabilities.
And now that Second Fleet is up and running, its NATO counterpart is expected to reach full operational capacity in 2021. Carla Babb, VOA News, Norfolk, Virginia.